I had to get a water on it. Come and get Jesus. You'll never thirst ever again. He's the living water. When you invite him into your heart, into your body, he heals you from the inside out. Just like drinking this water. You drink it. It goes all throughout your body and it heals you. That's what Jesus does when he comes in. He makes everything new. One sip. He gives it all to you. Peace, love, mercy, grace, healing. Well, he does.
How are you?
Good. Well, we're preaching the word over here. Giving the word. Yep. I'm on. Well, Jesus is on this one. And he's prepared me to read some scriptures and stuff. And he wants everybody to make their way over here. And we're reading the word to you, and we're just, you know, whatever Jesus wants to do, he does. He's awesome. And he's faithful. Well, I just declare and I decree his great faithfulness, Lord. You're a faithful God. You're a good God. You're great. You're worthy to be praised. You're holy, holy, holy. So today we're gonna read Isaiah 11. We're gonna go ahead and read that right now. He's instructed me, so I'm just gonna stay with what he instructed. It's his will. So we're gonna read Isaiah 11. And And there shall come forth a rod out of the stem of Jesse, and a branch shall grow out of his roots. And the Spirit of the Lord shall rest upon him, the Spirit of wisdom and understanding, the Spirit of counsel and might, the Spirit of knowledge and of the fear of the Lord, and shall make him of quick understanding in the fear of the Lord. And he shall not judge after the sight of his eyes, neither reprove after the hearing of his ears, but with righteousness shall he judge the poor, and reprove with equity for the meek of the earth. And he shall smite the earth with the rod of his mouth, and with the breath of his lips shall he slay the wicked. The righteous shall be the girdle of his loins, and faithfulness the girdle of his reins. The wolf also shall dwell with, and the leopard shall lie down with the kid, and the calf and the young lion, and the fatling together, and a little child shall lead them. And the cow and the bear shall feed, the young ones shall lie down together, and the lion shall eat straw like the ox, and the sucking child shall play on the hole of the ass, and the weaning child shall put his hand on the cockatrice den. Then shall no hurt, no destroy in all my holy mountain. For the earth shall be full of the knowledge of the Lord, as the waters cover the sea. And in that day there shall see a root of Jesse, which shall stand for in the sight of the people. To it shall the Gentiles seek, and his rest shall be glorious. And it shall come to pass in that day that the Lord shall set his hand again the second time to recover the remnant of his people, which shall be left from Assyria and from Egypt and from Tartarus and from Cush and from Elam and from Eshnar and from Amoth and from the islands of the sea. And he shall set up an ensign for the nations and shall assemble the outcasts of Israel and gather together the dispersed of Judah from the four corners of the earth. The envy also of Ephraim shall depart, and the adversaries of Judah shall be cut off. Ephraim shall not envy Judah, and Judah shall not vex Ephraim. But they shall fly upon the shoulders of the Philistines toward the west. They shall spoil them out of the east together. They shall lay their hand upon Edom and Moab, and the children of Amon shall obey them. And the Lord shall utterly destroy the tongue of Egypt in sea. And when his mighty wind shall he shake his hand over the river, and shall smite it in the seven streams, and make them go over dry shod. And there shall be a highway for the remnant of his people, which shall be left from Assyria, right as it was in Israel in the day that he came up out of the land of Egypt. Thank you, Father, for your word. Oh, thank you, Lord, for your word today. Thank you for your grace. Jesus.